Hey guys, Jarek and Wrapthor here, gonna be doing some more Project M. This video is entirely Charizard vs. Mewtwo, and tonight you were having a lot of troubles with this matchup.
Well, because range, for one, and plus I was getting extremely tired. As you notice, my...
Oh, the tired Johns.
Okay, well, whatever. You wanna keep talking shit? I kick your ass in this. You already know it. I'm definitely way better than you.
I cannot.
You're gonna sit there and listen to me be conceited.
I can legitimately say I don't think any one of us are better than each other at this point anymore.
I really don't care. If I really want to play competitively, I don't know. If I do play serious, I'll probably piss you off, to be honest.
Don't try to lie, though. I mean, you were trying to win here, but I think this is just a bad matchup for Mewtwo, to be honest. Because it's like, your Mewtwo has no problem fighting against my Marth. I mean, for the most part...
Well, no, to be honest...
The wins aren't entirely even. I think that would be about 60-40 split in your favor.
This is my excuse. I am definitely was getting tired after the Marth one. But this one, I just wanted to fight your Charizard, just because you haven't used it for some reason.
Well, I was practicing with Roy, because Roy is a lot harder to use. Something about Smash that I like is, I mean, like I said before, you can have two different people playing the same character and you can tell who is who by the different playstyles.
Yeah.
And
I definitely have a different playstyle with Marth.
Yeah, that's definitely the thing. I'm much more of a zoning type person when I play as Marth.
I'm more aggressive.
Yeah, I'm not that aggressive. I'm not really completely passive either. But I usually try to do perfect zoning setups. And I guess that's probably why Charizard feels so natural to me, because there's always that one character in Smash that just feels really natural to that specific person.
So natural.
Well, I mean, you can't say when you picked up some character in Project M that it just felt natural to you to use, and you were instantly pretty decent with it. Yeah, and like for me, this is definitely Charizard, and this is definitely one of my mains. So, I mean, it just felt easy for me to pick up, and I also haven't used Charizard in a while either, so I mean, you didn't really know what I was going to do, since my playstyle kind of has changed recently too.
Sorry, I just saw his head expanding when he did that non-move.
Okay, yeah, that's definitely something for you guys to watch. Charizard's forward tilt, that head chomp move, his head grows like 5 times in size.
I don't know, I just saw it, like, in slow motion in my mind.
I freeze-framed it, I just paused it when I was editing a previous Project M video and saw it and took a screenshot. I was like, what? I mean, they've done that before in, you know, like Mario's Fist and everything. It's just, this looks so silly.
I just can't unsee it every time I, like, see you do that move. Like, damn it, I'm seeing that big head.
No, but I probably should clarify there. I am definitely not better than you, like, for the people watching. This, I think, is just a really, really bad matchup for Mewtwo. I honestly believe that.
Yeah.
And on top of that, you didn't quite have mind games down yet, didn't know what I was going to do, or really have reads. So...
I don't know, every time I try to approach you, I get hit first, like, what? See, but he has more first priority. And it was definitely the range, because look at me, I'm just pulling combos here. And then suddenly that shit happens, like, what the fuck the hell?
Charizard is heavy, he's floaty, yeah, and he's pretty good at recovering, so...
Fucking lose weight! Fucking get out of Walmart!
So yeah, it's... Yeah,
and that too, that catches me off guard. I was like, fuck, I keep forgetting about that.
I need to use it more, but I don't want to use it so much to where you know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
So, I mean... Yeah, Charizard is a good character for me to use. I'm so used to having to zone people out with Marth's sword to begin with that it feels closely to the same. It's like a floaty Marth to me. That's what it feels like.
Yeah.
I mean, for the most part, the same tricks work when you're recovering just forward air, and that'll get people off of you. So, yeah, it just feels like it was natural to me. But yeah, I just wanted to clarify, I am definitely, I don't want to consider myself better than you, and I don't want people
don't
to think
care.
That they are.
I really don't care, I was just, like, talking shit.
Well, that's my point, because you know someone's going to be talking mad garbage in the comments.
Maybe. There's always that one kid that nobody likes, well, thumbs down him anyways. It's true.
But at this point, I really do think that it's like, neither of us are better than each other, and it's character matchups.
I'm just trying to have fun. That's all it is.
Okay, having fun is winning to me. It's like, I can have fun while digging around.
I can have fun, whatever. If I lose, I'll just keep playing because I'm enjoying myself.
So. I guess it depends on the amount of losing you're talking about, because if you're just going in getting 4-stocked or 3-stocked over and over again, then, you know, you're getting a little bit frustrating.
You're the one who's getting frustrated. I just accepted, like, fuck this. I'm gonna still kill you. I'm still gonna try this. I do manage to get you to one life at, like, most points when I do, like, screw up a lot, suicides.
I'm definitely more of a momentum player. If things aren't going well in a game for me, I'm probably not gonna win that game because I'm so mad at what's going on.
Yeah, like, you fucking almost quit on me, you bitch.
If I get to the point where it's like 3 stocks to 1 and they still have like low percentage on the third stock, I'll just suicide.
Whose fault is that? You're the one who keeps falling off doing stupid suicide.
I didn't say suicide. I just meant if you're flat out like bodying me. That's what I pretty much meant. Like, if you're up 3 stocks to 1, I'm just gonna suicide and call it, you know, a game. That's fine. I haven't done that in a long time, though.
No, I mean, well, most of the time, I do suicide by accident.
I'm not gonna lie. I do suicide a lot.
That's hilarious. But you're like, fuck this, I just fucking quit. I'm like, no, I was enjoying myself.
In all reality, when was the last time I've done that, though? Very, very long time ago.
Not even long time, no, we did it tonight. Shut
tonight?
Up.
When did I quit when I suicided?
I think
tonight?
It was the Roy. One of the Roy matches.
Did I? No, I didn't suicide.
That was yesterday, actually. Never mind. That was yesterday.
That was hilarious. We didn't play yesterday. We played like the day before yesterday. But yeah, main point being, I am... It's good. I've actually improved a lot compared to before, though.
You trying to use my combo?
Your combo? A lot of things, actually, a lot of things work out of Charizard's down throw.
Yeah. Well, you kind of barely use it. I remember he used to use his forward throw, his shitty back throw, especially his up throw.
His back throw it's so weak, but it works. It works like Marth's back throw, really, where you throw him back off just off the stage and then down smash them.
I guess it's kind of a setup in a way.
It really is, but it's you're used to, like, say, Luigi's back throw that will kill you.
What do you expect? Look at those tiny arms!
I guess that's the other reason I'm kind of getting better with Charizard compared to Marth, is that I still am kind of working around changing Marth's throws into actual attacks. I'm still not very good at that. And Charizard, it just feels a lot easier to chain things into other things. Like, just stand there and eat it.
Well, I was still afraid because I was like, for some reason I was doing really bad. I have 1 stock, and yeah, so I'm trying to play cautious.
But
I was trying to get quick, cheesy ones like that, trying to spike you immediately.
That's probably the other thing, is like, spiking Charizard doesn't necessarily work, because he can recover really well.
Yeah, he's actually one of the good characters that can actually recover from spike easily. I don't know what it is. It could be because of the extra jump, to be honest.
His recovery just in general, when it comes to Charizard, he has that glide and come back from pretty much anywhere outside of the stage.
Yeah.
I mean, you can intercept that, but he can also attack out of it. His triple jump is pretty high after doing 3 jumps to begin with. So, I mean, he's just in general a really, really hard character to get off stage. And he's fat.
I really hope he's an aerial. He has wings.
Oh, what about Spyro?
But he's not even in this game. What the fuck?
Yeah, but he can't fly up until the last Legend of Spyro game.
Look how tiny his wings! So, whatever.
I should have down-throwed you there. That would have killed you.
Other than that, I think Charizard has a really decent grab range, too.
Okay, maybe it's just because I'm so used to Marth's incredibly long grab range. I don't know. His grab range feels short to me. Like, I'm always just
look
out of range when I try to grab people.
Look at that giraffe neck, what are you talking about? You can reach, like, mountains.
But yeah, his throws in general, his up throw is a kill move, his down throw can be chained into a lot of different things, like his regular, just like his wing, neutral A.
I actually like that, because it actually,
it pops him upward, so you can do more things.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good for chaining. You can do that, or you can do your down tilt, which is that tail thing. Like, really, it works with almost any of his faster short moves. Like, I actually saw someone online do it correctly where he did a down throw and then he did a quick neutral air and killed someone, which I didn't think would work, but it works. So, you know, he just has a lot of kill options, he has a lot of recovery options,
I really hate that stupid forward smash where it pulls him back.
I love that too. So if you don't know his forward smash, what can I compare it to? Like, what else?
Like a wolf, kind of.
Kind of, but melee characters have that?
Like, move back a little bit?
Yeah. Captain Falcon a little bit.
Sonic's punch. Yeah, Captain Falcon, Ganondorf, Bowser?
Bowser. Bowser's a good comparison. Where it pulls his whole body backward, and so that if you, like, swing at him, you miss, and then you just catch it right to the face. And it's probably going to kill you.
Yeah.
Also, he's also another character that has an up B that will kill you very, very well.
I forgot to say something about Bowser about that. Like, his forward smash, they give him the Giga Bowser smash.
Why did they do that?
It is so fucking strong. You can kill someone like maybe 30% or 50. That's just crazy.
But yeah, this, you know, I'm still trying to exactly come up with what it is about this matchup that is so difficult for Mewtwo. Maybe it's the fact that both of them are floaty characters, both of them are hard to gimp. It's a little bit easier to deal with Mewtwo's recovery with Charizard since you can just kind of fly out towards them.
I honestly think it's your recovery. Like, when I'm looking at it, you're getting out of my juggles. Other than that, you're fat, I have a hard time killing you, so that's why I'm actually trying to resort to spiking.
Yeah, that's the other thing, is a lot of games I won where I definitely took more damage than you. Like, without a doubt, took more damage.
I really hate this. Bowser has the same shit, too. It racks up damage.
It's... Well, you might be able to just DI away from it, then do a teleport behind him.
No, you'll probably end up in the fire. That, I kind of messed up. I thought I was going to land on the edge, but I did the move, and you can't grab when you're doing the move.
But yeah, that's possibly the other thing, is it does seem that characters are good in the air. Mewtwo seems to have a little bit more of a trouble with, since he is an aerial character himself. And Charizard has more range. Like, easily has more range.
I really do like that they give Mewtwo that hover move.
Yeah, that definitely does give Mewtwo a lot more options, and stalling, it's really good for mind games.
It throws you off, especially like you're expecting him to fall in a normal velocity.
Like when
he'll just float.
Yeah, like when I'm charging, say, like Ike's neutral B move and you just float instead of landing. It's an easy way to catch a fair into the face. And you lose because of it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, other than that, I really can't decide what it is, because none of my other main characters are good against Mewtwo, for sure. Roy, no. Absolutely no fighting Mewtwo with Roy.
Yeah, stunlocked crazy.
Stunlocked and easily gimpable. Especially if, like, floating over and just doing a down air. There's no way Roy's gonna come back from that.
And other than that, Mewtwo can actually pull the wall of back air with his tail.
That freaking shit, too. Yeah, that many times you have done that to me.
See, with that, my reaction was so slow. I could have done that Shadow Claw, but I just float more.
What else is it? That's not necessarily too bad of a matchup for Mewtwo, but definitely not. I mean, that's like 60-40 in Mewtwo's favor. I love that forward smash. It's strong. I honestly think Ike would go in Ike's favor, Ike versus Mewtwo. Because Ike is pretty good, I mean, he has a pretty decent recovery as is, and he's pretty good at fighting against floaty characters.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'll be honest, I'm not good with Ike. Like, I have a lot of practicing to do before I consider him good.
I'm still looking forward to if, like, we ever find a place to have, like, a bunch of people we use this to play. And I would love to do team matches. We can definitely pull a Fire Emblem team, because I can use any character, to be honest.
I've always kind of been more of a, I don't really experiment with a lot of other characters. I prefer to have
Because you're picky!
Well, yeah, one, I'm picky, and two, I prefer to have a few characters I'm good with.
Yeah, I know that, but I'm just saying, like, if we ever do, it'll be great. Like, I would love to play a team matchup, you know?
Yeah. It's...
Yeah, we can play Pokemon like this. It could be Charizard and Mewtwo.
Poke Battle!
Well, not really a Pokemon, it's like, we could just dominate the other team. It's like, what the fuck is this Pokemon nerd shit? No, I don't know.
Pokemon nerd shit.
Then again, the players are playing the same game. I don't know.
Yeah, but that honestly is my main reason for not... I love Charizard's up air. Or is up throw. Usually that would kill.
Yeah, because I'll DI
for a lifetime.
DI for a lifetime.
But honestly, that is the main reason I don't use other characters, is that they don't really appeal to me.
Like, yeah, it is a personal choice thing. Like, you could probably play good with Olmar. It's just that, like, fuck, this character's retarded. So you don't want this. You'd rather pick a character that's cool, badass, has some kind of reputation. I don't know.
And that's, like, you know, the only characters that really appealed to me in Melee were basically Roy. And I only started using Marth because Marth is Roy.
Yeah, and plus he couldn't really compete with the better characters, I guess. And to me, for Fox, he's just... I grew up with Star Fox, so yeah, I was a big fan, so...
That's the thing, is like...
character. The only reason I stopped using it is because he's just really cheap with that reflector off the edge crap. And I really feel really bad doing that in, like, tournaments. Even to my friend, they would get pissed off and quit the game.
In tournaments, in tournaments, I can't feel bad doing that, because that's a win no matter what. Friendlies,
it's really
not
cheesy,
the same.
Though. It's like edgehogging. It's fucking irritating.
But sometimes you have to use that when you're playing a character that you know is better than you.
Yes.
Like, if you went up against someone like Mewtwo King, like, there is no way you
would. When you think about it, it's like, if you play a game without edgehogging or any type of, like, cheap crap like that, the match would be epic. But if you're gonna end the match like that, that is fucking boring. Two, it's not really skill, it's being cheesy. It's, you know, people, I'm pretty sure a lot of people are gonna understand what I'm saying. It's cheesy.
I do. Maybe the reason I don't care against edgehogging very much is because edgehogging with someone like Marth is definitely not cheap. More difficult to do.
Like I said, like, I don't really do it at all because, one, it will piss people off, so I am strongly against it. So that's why you'll notice I'll never, like, edgehog you on purpose, even though I could. I'd rather stick to the basic and try to spike you because that's how it's supposed to be, you know?
Well, when you say edgehogging, that basically is hedgehogging, but I don't know what specifically
you
mean.
No, that's edgeguarding. Edgeguarding is like just waiting and, you know, waiting for them to come back. Edgehogging is...
If I know you're not going to make it back, I'm definitely going to grab the ledge.
If you're grabbing the ledge, just taking the animation and then having them not grab it, it's fucking irritating, it's cheesy, and it makes you stupid. Somehow.
So also, I love that upbeat kill.
Yeah, that caught me off guard.
I really do.
I keep forgetting about that. I don't know why.
I love how that kills. It has a lot of knockback to it. But if you're coming back and I know you're going to just barely make the ledge, I'm definitely going to grab the ledge. And usually what I'll try to do with Marth is the spike off of it, but it's a lot harder to do in this compared to melee. It still works. I mean, I can still do it.
Like I said, even though I would do it, it's just I rather... Like, you noticed, I could get the kill, I'll throw you the opposite direction if you haven't noticed that, because I love it. I love playing with my food, so that's what I'm gonna do. If you have a high percentage, I could kill you. I'm just gonna throw you the other edge and do some more combos, because I'm having fun.
It's like, if I know I'm gonna win, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
You know, if I know I'm not going to win, I won't mess around.
Yeah, that's why sometimes I'll try to go for a cheap spike.
I love, like, this stage.
This stage was really bad for me. I don't know.
Well, the thing with this stage is that it has a really low ceiling, and I like to abuse that because, you know, Charizard's a kill upward type character.
I was trying to get you. He's like, fuck you, I'm going to get you in my range then.
Yeah, Charizard definitely has more range than Mewtwo, without a doubt. Yeah, this is honestly the only character I feel like I can competently fight against Mewtwo, and I feel like I have some sort of a really advantage.
Huh.
Because, like I said, Roy and Marth aren't really great against him. Roy's terrible against him. Marth is meh. Ike is, you know, good against him, but I'm not really that great with Ike. I don't know why you did that.
Like I said, I'm all just off. Like,
just not feeling it tonight.
It just drained, because, one, I came home from work, and it was like, I'm bored, boy.
Oh, the work jaunts.
I wanna lay down on my bed and play my video games, and be lazy.
But yeah, you know, it's actually hard to come up with other characters that I think Mewtwo has a hard time against. Like, what would Mewtwo even be bad against?
I can probably say... I want to say Bowser for some reason. I'm pretty sure there's a really good Bowser and, of course, Captain Falcon.
Falcon, I feel like, would not be very good against Mewtwo at all because of that recovery.
I guess. Yeah, you're right. I could probably spike him when he's trying to...
And he gets stunned bad. I still like how you originally thought this was a Pokemon level.
I thought, because I saw those birds, I thought it was like, you know those legendary bird like Ho-Oh?
Yeah, but like... It had Link music, it had Zelda music.
I wasn't paying attention to the music, and probably it was a time when, you know, you were recording and we had to turn down the volume.
Yeah, for those of you that don't know, if we do live commentary for Smash Brothers in general...
If we do, like, okay, I'll probably say if we were streaming, that would make sense.
Well, yeah, because you need live commentary for streaming. You need to interact with viewers and stuff like that. When we record, though, I use a condenser mic, which is, you know, a mic that you'd usually find for, like, a podcast or whatnot. So it picks up everything, so I need to turn the speakers down. Yeah. And I don't have a headphone splitter, so we need to turn things down, so...
Yeah, which is dumb. I can't really play like that.
And plus, it honestly does throw me off.
I'm trying to, you know. You wanted to do that earlier, but I was like, no, I really don't want to hear all the clickety clack because one, there's always gonna have that one person that's like, the controller noises, clickety clack clack clack. That's all they're gonna say in the comment. That's it. And I don't know.
See, after being on YouTube for so long,
his weird.
His spike is like stubby so leg.
Like, yeah,
it'd be like getting stepped on by a fat person.
Pretty much. It's fucking Snorlax mode.
I feel like Snorlax is more like King DDD.
Yeah.
What was I saying? Right, now, after you're on YouTube for so long and you're a fairly well-known person, you ignore what people say. Like, you know there's going to be that stupid person that'll say that stupid thing, but you just ignore the comment or remove it. Both.
And that's why he gets that thumbs down and nobody likes it. Yeah.
I remember when I first started playing as Charizard, I suicided a lot, because that wing fire move pushes you backward. So, I also am not using it as much because it has a lot of delay after you do it, so if you miss, you're boned.
See that fucking shit, fucking pullback.
But yeah, like I was saying, I legitimately can't think of any other characters other than possibly Ike and Charizard that give Mewtwo a hard time. Maybe Jigglypuff.
I don't know, I'm thinking Falco for some reason.
I honestly don't think that any...
fuck, I couldn't grab it. I don't know why.
All going for the balloon. Suddenly the balloon is the biggest enemy.
Okay, for some reason, every time we play Battle of this, everybody just have to hit the balloon or the shy guy. I don't know what it is.
The shy guy makes sense because that will like stop your move for a minute and mess you up. Or if you're someone like, say, recently saw a tournament where someone was playing as Lucario and they were on Yoshi's Island, the Brawl Yoshi's Island. I don't remember. What is that map even called? Is it just Yoshi's Island?
No, I don't even know what you're talking about.
You know what level I'm talking about, though.
No, I don't.
It's the level with the dicks.
Oh.
And the Shy Guys would come down, and he used that big Aura Ball, but it hit a Shy Guy, and it would have gotten a kill, but it disappeared after it hit the Shy Guy.
Really?
That made it go away entirely. And then he lost because of it. That was, like, game point. So, I mean, I can understand why people hate Shy Guys, but the balloons literally have no point. They're there. Fuck balloons, I guess.
Yeah.
Oh god, almost suicided.
Okay, that's not what. I don't know what's been going on with tonight. Every time we go near the edge and we're about to hit each other, for some reason it like increased gravity. It's so weird. That's why you notice like some of the suicide when we're by the edge and we'll just go straight down. It's like, what just happened?
I think what's going on is that like there's still some momentum left over. Yeah, and you know how when you grab the ledge it makes you invulnerable for a moment, and then that vulnerability goes away and suddenly you're moving again. Something, I want to know if it still works. I would assume you know the back air that Marth has in Melee would stop momentum entirely, right?
I don't remember.
Well, for example, say if you like do a...
All I know is it does turn you around, which I did like.
Yeah, I like that, but what I mean is like, say you do an up B off of a ledge, and someone hits you, and you tech off that wall, you would still continue going forward from the momentum usually, but if you do the back air, it stops you in place.
I didn't know that.
I don't know if that still works. It's very situational, but I would like to see. I just haven't gotten into a situation where I really needed to.
I can't stop looking at that pink thing on the right corner. What the fuck is that?
Why does it remind
ugly? Other than that, I'll just look at that little raccoon thing or whatever that is. Tanuki thing. Is it a tanuki? What's a tanuki? Whatever.
I don't know.
Look at that little raccoon.
That freaking thing on the right reminds me of Rugrats.
What? Oh yeah. That's what I was looking at the whole time when I was playing this. Like, I just wanted to blurt that. I was like, what the fuck is that? It's just smiling. And I noticed that they follow you. Like,
yeah, I honestly didn't know that. Or did I notice that?
Well, I'm pretty sure they look at the... I wanted to quit. Like, fuck! I don't know. I was so off. I don't know. I couldn't do it. But, yeah. I'm tired. My throat hurts.
Man, you go.
There are so many dicks. No, I'm kidding.
Hey, I didn't get a chance to see the stars. I didn't move my hand.
You had 107.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, that's been some more Project M. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and see you later.